Hello students, in this lecture we will take pneumatic air compressor. So pneumatic air compressor will start. So in this functioning of air compressor is that air is compressed and stored inside the air receiver. The function of air compressor is to reduce the volume and increase the pressure in the compressed air. As name indicates, air compressor. The main function of the is to convert electric energy to the kinetic energy. So air compressor, so it takes an atmospheric air, compresses the air so as to increase the pressure and transfers the compressed air into a air receiver. So this is a diagrammatical representation. Types of air compressors. So different types are there: reciprocating or piston compressors, rotary sliding vane compressors, rotary screw, centrifugal. In next slide we will take in detail, that is a in tree diagram. This diagram shows compressor types, that is a positive displacement or dynamic. Positive displacement is again divided into reciprocating and rotary, and this reciprocating compressor is a divided into single acting and double acting, also diaphragm type. And this rotary type of compressors are different types, that is a lobe compressor, screw compressor, vane compressor, liquid ring, scroll. So these are the different types under rotary. Then in dynamic compressors are the centrifugal and axial compressors. So first we will take reciprocating piston compressor. So diagrammatical representation of this reciprocating piston compressor is as shown in this diagram. So in this reciprocating piston compressor, it compresses a gas or air using a piston which is driven inside the reciprocal way. The gas or air enters and is stored in a pressurized cylinder. Later the gas is released through valves. Reciprocating air compressor, it works on the principle of positive displacement. Single stage compressor operated by one cylinder only, normally up to 4 bars. Multi-stage compressors are used for higher operating pressures, normally up to 15 bars for double stage compressors. So in the reciprocating air compressor, single stage reciprocating air compressor, as shown in this diagram, vacuum is created when piston moves downward. So this piston, when moves downward, vacuum is created and suction valve opens due to the atmospheric pressure, and air enters the cylinder via air filter. So this suction valve opens and air enters to that cylinder. So operation of single stage in a discharge stroke, volume of air is reduced when the piston moves upward and pressure increases and is now higher than the pressure in the air receiver. Pressure of the higher side will force open the discharge valve. Compressed air is discharged to the air receiver. So this is a function of reciprocating air compressor. Then next is a diaphragm type of compressor. So diagrammatical representation is as look like this. Is similar to the reciprocating air compressor, but diaphragm is as shown in this structure. Then next is a sliding vane rotary compressor. So sliding vane rotary compressor diagrammatical representation is as shown in this diagram. So this sliding vane rotary compressor consists of a cylindrical block with radial slots. So these are the radial slots which is mounted inside circular casing with an offset. The vanes are inserted in the radial slot. The vanes are always held against the casing by centrifugal force or spring force. Okay, when the rotor rotates, the air is drawn from atmosphere, gets trapped in the packets between the rotor. These are the packets between the rotor and vanes and casting carried from the inlet to outlet and delivered. Then next is a this is a view of a sliding fan compressor. Comprises a cylinder that is placed inside the water jacket cylinder. The rotor forces the air against the wall, thereby compressing the air and releasing it afterwards. Next is a screw compressor. So this is a diagrammatical representation of screw compressor. It consists of two helically grooved. These are the two helically grooved rotors. The motor male rotor has lobes and the female rotor has a gullies. Okay. The male rotor is a driver and female rotor is a driven. The lobes will exactly mesh the gullies. The two rotors are in mesh with each other. There are no suction and discharge valves. The gap between casing, this is a gap between casing and rotor, is called as a pocket. The pocket size goes on reducing from the inlet towards outlet. So this is a screw compressor. This is a diagrammatical representation of screw compressor. This type of a compressor uses two rotors, out of which one is male and other is female, as previously mentioned. Okay, so observe, this is a rotary screw compressor. Then next is a lobe compressor. So this lobe compressor, we can explain here. Two lobes are shown here. It consists of two rotors mounted inside the casting. Two rotors. The rotors are mesh with each other. These are the mesh with each other. One is a driver and other is a driven. Okay. When the driver rotor is rotated with the help of prime mover, the driven rotor will also rotate. So there is a movement. One is a driver and another is a driven. Okay. So air gets trapped in the packets. This air gets trapped in the packet between rotor and casting, and carried by rotors from inlet to outlet. Then next is an axial flow compressor. So this axial flow compressors, diagrammatical representation is as shown in the diagram. Axial flow air compressor consists of a rotor, a stator. A rotor is mounted on a frictionless bearing. Hence it is free to rotate. Stator blades are fixed to fixed set of blades. Okay. So this is an axial flow compressor. Then next is a centrifugal compressor. So centrifugal compressor diagram is as shown in this figure, also known as radial compressors, and this comprises of pumps, blowers and fans. It consists of impeller mounted inside the volute casing with the diffuser. Okay. So this is a detailed diagram of a centrifugal compressor, and air can be compressed with the help of this centrifugal compressor. Uses of compressed air, it is used in pneumatic tools, hand grinders, then chisels, screwdrivers, operate pneumatic systems, cleaning machines, part and components, start up large diesel engines. These air compressors are used. Then air receiver, to store compressed air, to stabilize compressed air supply, to smoothen pressure pulsation, and also to dry the compressed air by allowing water vapor to precipitate. Okay, so air receiver is used to store the compressed air. Then next is the parts of a reciprocating compressor. These are the part, that is a pressure gauge, then start stop switch. Pressure gauge indicate the pressure in the air receiver. Start or stop switch, as name indicates, manually switch on off the electric motor. Automatic cut in or out relay, to start the motor automatically when the pressure drops to the lower set point. To stop motor automatically when the system has reached the upper set pressure. reciprocating air compressor. Detail components diagram is as shown in this figure. This is a pressure gauge. Then second, this is a start or stop switch. Then third is a autocut in out relay. Then fourth is a filter. So this is a filter, air filter. And next is a relief valve. Fifth is a relief valve. This is a relief valve. Then sixth is a drain valve. So this is a drain valve. Then seven is a air receiver. So this is a air receiver. And eight is a compress block. This is a compress block or compressor block. Nine is a flywheel and cooling fan. So this is a flywheel and cooling fan. 10, this is a discharge line. So this is a discharge line. Then 11 is a drive belt. So this is a drive belt. Then 12, this is a guard. These are the guard. Then 13, motor is used. 14, power supply. So this is a power supply. And 15 is a air supply line. So this is a air supply line. So these are the main components of a reciprocating air compressor. So drain valve to drain off water accumulated in air received due to condensation. Air receivers to storage tank for compressed air to maintain air pressure in the system. Then compressor block contain the working parts of the compressor, inlet valve out and outlet valve, piston. Then next is a crankshaft. Then connecting rods are also there. Then parts of reciprocating compressor, cooling fan. Here is blown over a fine compressor block for cooling, attached to the flywheel and rotate together with the crankshaft. So these are the details of the air compressor. So in detail we have taken air compressor, that is the types of air compressors, then function of air compressor and different components of the air compressor in detail. So in exam, explain air compressor, what are its different types, explain in detail. If such type of a question asks, you can mention in details.